6:18 and time now for What's Trending. We'll get ready for some hearty comfort food. It's National Great American Pot Pie Day on September 23rd. And you can celebrate the day by going out to a restaurant for a pot pie, cooking a frozen one at home, or making one from scratch. Similar to meat pies, pot pies are distinctly American. A typical pot pie contains ingredients such as chicken, beef, or pork, vegetables, and gravy. But there are endless possibilities. The first frozen pot pies were introduced by Swanson Foods in the 1950s, and National Great American Pot Pie Day was created in 2002 by another frozen foods maker. You can post to social media hashtag National Great American Pot Pie Day, I guess, with your pot pie. I love pot pies. I don't know about y'all, but it took me a long time to kind of get into it. But my mom, she would make some from scratch, and at home at Costco's, they actually make a really good one. That's, I guess it's like kind of frozen, but it's really good. Do y'all like pot pies?
I love it. My mom also makes it. Shout out to my mom. Hello. She would do like the Betty Crocker one. But she's a phenomenal cook. But yeah, you can't beat a good pot pie when the steam comes out and you have all your veggies for the day.
And then you also
have the crust.
Yes.
It's so good. You can't beat it.
Delicious.
You can't beat it at all. And you know, memory's failing me right now. I can't remember if my family makes any or not. But I know I've had the store brand before where you just heat it up in the microwave. And that is also delicious.
Yeah.
So I'm also a pot pie. I usually get like chicken pot pies a lot of times.
You said you like the one with turkey,
you can
too.
Do turkey
you can
pot
do turkey
pie, too, which is great for Thanksgiving, and then have a little dollop of cranberry sauce on the side.
Ooh.
It's really good. I highly recommend it.
And some time for the cranberry harvest coming up soon, too.
Oh,
so
really?
Bringing all this in here to harvest season.
I'm
so
hungry
for fall.
Perfect for fall to enjoy some chicken, enjoy any kind of pot pie today, I should say.
Yeah.
Well, perfect. Well, what's pink, edible, and grown to help support breast cancer research? That would be porcelain doll pumpkins. Pat White has been growing the gourds for 5 years in Palmyra, Maine. White says he saw pink pumpkin seeds in a catalog 1 year and wanted to see if they would grow in Maine. White sells his pumpkins for $5 each and donates all the funds to raise a champion for the cure. All the money will go towards cancer treatment and research. He said it's hard to grow this variety and you would have to put the seeds in early and then put a blanket on top of the pumpkins to keep them warm at nighttime. White also says a lot of them have different stories, and you know, they always have a relative who's had breast cancer. Well, that's amazing.
Okay.
I've never seen a pink pumpkin before. That's really,
really
pretty, and that's so good to be doing it for a great cause.
Yeah, that's really sweet, and I love how he kind of realized that, you know, the people who come and get his pumpkins have a relative who has breast cancer or is a survivor or anything. So I think it's a great way to, I feel like a lot of people have been using pumpkins for great things. Like we talked about the kid yesterday, he's raising money for his college funds. I mean, it's a great thing.
You can do almost anything with pumpkins too, to do something cool, like in this case here. And if I understood this correctly, this is the way the pumpkins grow. You're not decorating it afterwards. This is just how it's grown, right?
Yeah, it's just grown pink. It's really
interesting. And that's just amazing to think about. And speaking of pink, we're all wearing pink coincidentally today. So I'm not sure if this was part of this might have been planned, but part of it may not have been either.
On Thursdays, we wear pink.
Or any day, right?
And especially because, like, the pumpkins, it's a luxury to have. Who has a pink pumpkin? I would love a pink pumpkin. And you can use it for decorating your house or for basically anything and just spruce up everything a little bit more. It's a little more fancy.
Yeah, any decorations can make things fun, especially a pink pumpkin.
Exactly.
But meanwhile, though, speaking of interesting things, Conor McGregor, one of the world's most well-known fighters, may also be one of the world's worst pitchers. Ouch. Tuesday night, the mixed martial arts star had a chance to throw out the ceremonial first pitch at Wrigley Field in Chicago before the Cubs faced the Twins. But as you can see, McGregor can't locate his pitches as well as his punches. His toss was so bad, it was like something out of a movie, perhaps a screwball comedy. This effort was surely joining the litany of worst first pitches and baseball, and that is just too funny. And to be honest, this is just too funny. I mean, to see this happening, and not too far away from Wisconsin either, and also with another team in the NL Division North here, or Central Division. I can't remember which division this is called, but it's too funny to just see this happen one of our neighboring teams there.
Yeah,
maybe he
really
got
bad.
Confused because I know they play cricket in England or Ireland or wherever he's from. So maybe he thought you throw it long. But he didn't even look like he was aiming.
Yeah,
I don't know what he's doing.
I think he knows. That was just something that was just really bad. I mean, you know, it's funny because you usually see him, you know, just talking stuff or whatever. It's like, you can't even pitch. No, it's fine. I probably couldn't either, to be
honest. Yeah, I'm sure my pitching is probably so bad right now, I probably would miss horribly and probably break something.
Oh, well, we don't want to do that then.
Yeah, we don't want to break any. That's usually my luck. Usually when I do something, something breaks.
Oh,
so
dear.
This is the old phrase, you can't trust me with anything. But yet, thankfully, our engineers trust us with the studio. So
yes,
I guess we can say
exactly
that they trust us with something today.
In the weather.
We love our engineers. I will say that right now.